going to show you how to make a very functional timesheet in Excel. Here we have the finished product, so I'm showing you what the features are of this timesheet. So we have the date starting at April 1st, and the days that are grayed out are the Saturday and Sundays. And you notice that it aligned for 31 days, and yet it only goes to 30 days, and it shows that the 31st day is the 1st of May, obviously. So let's change the date here. Let's change it from 4, let's say, to 2. And there you go. It knows that it's this was February, and there's 29 days in February, so that the 1st and 2nd would be March. Also, the dates that are grayed out have changed equally with the change of the month. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to select columns C to AH, or AG, I'm sorry, and we are going to change the width of the columns. And so we're going to go right, we've selected them, and we're going to right click, and we're going to column width, and we're going to put in 3. Okay, so what we're going to do in A1 is we're going to put in name. And below that in A2, we're going to put start date. Okay, so let's put in Tom Smith. And let's put in a start date of May 1st. So 5/1/2016. Press enter. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we are going to black out this column here. So we're going to change this to black. So then we're going to do is we're going to black out the first row from B to AJ, just so that we have some separation here, and so we can put that black as well. Now what this is going to be in here is the tasks, so that a lot of employers will want you to divide what you've done during the day so they can charge different rates for different hours. So let's type in tasks here. Okay, and then what we're going to do here is we're going to have the date. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go equal, and then I'm going to select our start date here. And that obviously doesn't fit in there. So what I'm going to do is right click, and I'm going to format the cells. And then I am going to select custom. And I am going to type in just day here. So D for day. And say OK. And so that gives you a 1. Right? So now what we're going to do is to create the next day is I'm going to go equals this date plus 1. And so then we have 1, 2. And so what we're going to do is we're going to grab the fill handle and we're going to drag down so we get 31 here. Okay, what we can do here now is we can put some boxes around here. So let's select this first row here, this border button, all borders. Okay, so now there's your dates done for you. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go down to the bottom here, and we're going to select another row that's on the bottom that's parallel to these. And we are going to put the same borders on this. And this is going to be the summing, the totaling up of the hours here. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit our automatic sum button. And we're going to select the spot where the hours are going to go in. And we're going to press enter. And then we're going to drag this across. Perfect. OK, Okay, so now what we're going to do is we are going to put boxes around here for you to enter your hours in. So we're going to select all these cells, and we are going to put boxes again. So now I'm going to figure out which days of this chart are weekends that need to be grayed out. So what I'm going to do is go into cell C2 here, and I'm going to go equals, and then I'm going to go weekday. And then I'm going to select our starting date, and I'm going to go put the ending bracket on it and press enter. So that's going to be 1. And so to drag it across, I'm going to have to go equals, and I'm going to go weekday again. And I'm going to select this one, which is our first date, and I'm going to go plus 1. And we'll go enter. And so now, if we drag that across, you can see that it goes to 7, 1 being Sunday and 7 being Saturday. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to conditionally format these days or these dates for the month. So if the weekday is equal to 1 or 7, we're going to change it to gray. So we're going to select the days of the month that we'd like to format. And then we're going to go to conditional formatting on the toolbar here, and we're going to select new rules. And I'm going to use a formula to determine the rule, and I'm going to click the little red arrow so we can select the data that we want to check. And here you have the data right here. This tends to put absolute reference on these cells, and we don't want that. So we don't want the C, so let's take the dollar sign out of the C and the dollar sign out of the AG. Okay, and then we go back and we say if these ones equal 1, then what we're going to do is we're going to change the format. And so what we're going to do is click on the format button, we're going to go to the fill, and we're going to select the second one from the bottom here, and we're going to say okay. And we're going to say OK. So now you have the days that are the Sunday grayed out, and we can do this, repeat the same form, the same operation for the Saturday. So if it's a 1 or a 7. Okay, so then you've got that, and the other thing that you need to do is we're going to select the bottom dates here, and this will be a simple conditional format. We'll go to conditional formatting. And we'll go like highlight cell rules that are greater than 8. And they'll say OK. So that means that anything that's over 8 hours will be highlighted. So the next thing is just some automatic sums. So what we're going to do is do an automatic sum horizontally here. So we're going to get our automatic sum button, and we're going to select from the first to the end of the month, and press enter, and then we can drag that down, and then we'll do a sum at the bottom of the totals that we've calculated already. What you can do is select these cells and put squares on each one of them. Now we can put in tasks here. Let's say task 1 and task 2. Okay, and then we'll put in a few hours here. So we'll go 5 and 4, and then we'll go 6 and 3. And so here you have the totals coming here for the tasks, and then you have the totals that are over 8 hours. Change to red so that you know that they're overtime. And so besides that, the other thing we can do here is we don't really need these dates up here. So what I'm going to do is formatting. This is a trick I use, is I'm going to change the font color to white and so that they disappear. So to finish this up, all you would do is formatting by putting some black underneath here and so on. So that is your quick functional timesheet in Excel. Please subscribe.